I like to move it, move it. Woo! I like to move it, move it, move it. I hate that song. However, my students at elementary school who I teach love it. They say it makes them happy. And when they're happy, they can handle all the stress and pressure from school so much better. Fellow Toastmasters, Contest Master, I recently had to move house. And the first thought that came to mind was, I don't like to move it, move it, move it. I don't. I'm a hard worker, but I'm lazy when it comes to physical work. I don't like moving my body to other heavy objects, and most of all, I don't like moving house. I don't like moving because it usually involves change. And I'd rather stay the same, thank you. It involves mental and physical effort. And I'd rather just be lazy. I love making excuses. Woo-hoo! I love postponing things. Yes! But what I love most of all is paying other people to do the moving for me. Take that into the kitchen. That goes into the living room. Move that upstairs. Be careful. It's expensive. Until my last move. I had to move from the first floor to the third floor. And I know what you're thinking. Probably not a big deal. I have news for you. For a lazy guy like me, it's huge. No elevator, no money in the budget. I did consider asking my friends for help, but there was this persistent little voice in my head that said, why not do it yourself? Followed by three other voices, my sneaky little friends, procrastination, self-doubt, and fear. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to imagine all this over here as all my earthly possessions. About this wide, this high, all packed, ready to be moved. The problem was, I didn't see that. I saw something 10 times higher, 10 times bigger, 10 times more work. In my mind, I created a mountain out of a molehill. How do you move a mountain? I decided to ask a very wise friend of mine, Google. According to Google, Confucius said, the man who moves a mountain starts by carrying away small stones. That's when it dawned on me that this was something I had to do. By myself, for myself. I still had that little voice in my head that said, you can do it. Just move it. I started moving my mountain, one box at a time. Up three floors until I got to the heavier, bigger stuff. And I just wanted to quit. But wait, I might be lazy, but I'm also very stubborn. And I made a decision that I will not be defeated by a bunch of stuff. So I pulled, and I pushed, and I cursed a lot, until I moved everything up to the third floor. Until it was only me and the refrigerator. And the first thing I thought of was, no, I can't get a refrigerator all by myself up three floors. But that's when I remembered my student song. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. And I could see that I often look at my problems from a distance and they look so big and impossible. But once I tackle them and I actually do something about it, it's actually quite easy. And you think, why did I ever doubt myself? I moved that fridge up three stairs. Not three stairs, three flights of stairs. I wish. When I put that fridge in its place on the third floor, I thought, I have moved my mountain. And I started to cry. I cried for every time that I didn't finish something that I started. I cried for every time I didn't believe in myself, and I cried for every time I made excuses. But most of all, I realized it was never really about moving. It was about changing. Changing my attitude allowed me to move my mountain. The biggest mountain is fear of change. And we have these mountains in our lives. Today I moved this mountain. There will be more to come, but I am ready and I have a plan of action. Move it, move it, move it. How do you begin to change? Lao Tzu said, the journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. Contest master.